As the second oldest event on the NHRA Drag Racing Series Tour, the Winter Nationals have a history that fills volumes for fans and enthusiasts alike. There have been literally hundreds of memorable sportsmen and final rounds run at this race since it was first held in Pomona in 1961. Picking five that stick out is a virtually impossible task, but we tried. These aren't the five greatest, the five most, well, anything final rounds, but they are five fabulous finals from the NHRA Winter Nationals throughout history. Number 5. Don Garlitz, 1963. 1963 was a huge and interesting year for the NHRA as nitromethane was allowed back at national event competition. Kind of. The Winter Nationals allowed nitro, the U.S. Nationals did not. But that's cool because at the one race where nitromethane was used, an NHRA class called Top Fuel was born, and an icon was birthed with it.
And Don Garlitz from Tampa, Florida, going against Art Malone, also from Florida. Coming out of the tire smoke is Don Garlitz, the winner in his Dodge-powered Swamp Rat 5, turning a lightning 186.32 in 8.26 seconds.
Number 4. 1981. Billy Meier. The 1981 Funny Car Final saw two rock stars of their day competing, Billy Meier and Raymond Beadle. In the prior round, the roof of the Blue Max was ripped off during competition. Fellow Texan and lifelong friend Kenny Bernstein let the Blue Max crew saw the roof off his car so Beadle could make the final round. The results were breathtaking.
Ready to go at the starting line. And Beadle sideways and comes back in line. A beautiful, masterly handling job by Beadle. He got his car straight, but he loses to Meier. And Meier wins the Winter National Funny Car Championship.
Number 3. Gary Selzy, 1997. When the 1997 season rolled around, Gary Selzy had landed one of the most coveted and frankly fearsome jobs in drag racing, taking over the seat in Alan Johnson's Top Fuel Dragster following the tragic loss of Johnson's brother Blaine in 1996, the expectations were high in Pomona. Selzy proved himself the man for the job immediately.
That's it up the final round, the five-time champ Farside, the rookie Nearside. Count how many times they stand on the gas.
Number 2. 1993. John Force. When John Force truly got his winning ways started in the 1990s, there were few who could legitimately call themselves challengers or even equals. As it turns out, one of them was a family race team from Southern California that had a smiling young kid named Dell behind the wheel. Here's how the final went down 30 years ago.
We're about to find out. It's Force with a hole shot. It's Force in front, and look at Dell. Oh, what a way to end Funny Car. John Force wins it on a hole shot, a 5.21 to a 5.19.
Number 1, Bill Jenkins, 1972. Bill Jenkins rolled into Pomona for the 1972 Winter Nationals with one of drag racing's greatest aces slid up his sleeve. His little Chevy Vega with a small block Chevy engine would wow the crowds and stop the competition cold in their tracks. In fact, during the 8-race 1972 season, Jenkins won 6 times and revolutionized pro stock in the process. Here's how it all started, the 1972 final round.
Benson, here we go. They're off. Looks like Jenkins got the start, so Sears coming at him, though. It's a very close race. It could be anybody's race. Here they come to the final, and it is Bill Jenkins comes across just ahead of Don Garlitz there.
Thanks for watching. Grab your Winter Nationals tickets today on NHRA.com and become part of history and legacy at the Winter Nationals.